friends, welcome back to another YouTube video. In today's video, we're going to talk about a very important question. And I get this question a lot, where a lot of you are asking if you need to learn math for data science. And if yes, then what level of math do you need? So I'm going to break down exactly that in this video. How much math do you need to know? What are the different types of math that you need to know depending on which role? This would likely be a short video, but I really hope that you find value in this. And if you do find value in this, hit like on this video and subscribe to my channel if you want to hear more about data science, tech lifestyle, and everything else in between. So let's break it down. Before we go into the data science part, let's just talk about specifically about what are the type of math that is out there. When we're talking about math, there are four types of math fields. So there is geometry, there's algebra, there's statistics and probability, and the fourth one is calculus. Now that we got that out of the way, let's jump into data science. So when we're talking about the data science, as I have previously mentioned in my other videos, data science is a huge umbrella. There are many roles under the data science umbrella. So depending on which role you are part of, what are your day-to-day job activities, you may or may not need a deep understanding. So what are the job families under data science umbrella? There is data scientist generalist, there is machine learning engineer, there is applied scientist, there is research scientist, there is data engineer, there is a data analyst, and I'm pretty sure there's a few other job families under the data science umbrella. I'm forgetting, feel free to drop them in comments. So now I'm gonna show you this Venn diagram. So on this Venn diagram, depending on where you are, you may or may not need a deep understanding of math. In the middle, there is data scientist generalist. At the bottom, you will have somebody who is like more close to the business, which is more on the data analyst side. Then on one side is like more computer science heavy, and the other side is more statistics and ML heavy. Statistics and probability is important for all of the roles on this Venn diagram. Maybe less important to some of the roles, but it is equally important to most of the data job families in here. Now let's go to the other type of maths, that is calculus and linear algebra. Who needs to know this type of math? In simple form, on the Venn diagram that I showed you, the closer you are to machine learning, the more familiar you would need to be with math. Data scientists, generalists, typically what they're doing, they are taking the pre-built models and then they are applying it to the business problems to solve it. When you go more toward ML and go more toward applied science, what you are doing is you are writing custom models. More often than not, you're not using those pre-built models, which means that you're gonna have to write your own formulas, your own models, which means that you need to understand the math behind it to be able to successfully execute on those models. Which means if you're planning to work on in roles which are writing custom sophisticated ML models, those are the roles where you would need to have a very good understanding of math. And they would need to know statistics, linear algebra, calculus, because you would be writing your own equations and your own math behind each model that you built. So to summarize, statistics and probability is needed for all data science roles, maybe less for a data engineer and data analyst, but pretty much like all the roles have to touch on statistics and probability. Having a limited understanding of linear algebra is going to help you even in a data scientist generalist role, which involves picking up pre-existing models and applying it, because sometimes you would have to explain the model or fine-tune the model. But now as you go into more ML heavy roles, which require you to write your own models, that's exactly when you would need a deep understanding of math. For those of you who are just starting out in the industry and trying to figure out how much math you need, I hope this is helpful to you and gives you some sort of direction and a path to create your learning plan. So with that, thank you so much for watching. Let me know in comments if you agree with this and if you have any other thoughts on math when it comes to data science. So I hope you're having a beautiful day and I'll talk to you later. Bye.